Hello everyone, I'm Charmeleon and welcome back to my channel, and this is my husband. This is a travel vlog and we are going to take you to Lübbenau Spreewald, a one-day day trip from Berlin. And if you're looking out for good summer destinations where you wanted to spend for weekend or one-day trip, this place is not going to disappoint you. I am at Osterkreuz S-Bahnhof, Berlin, waiting for my regional train, Cottbus, hop the Bahnhof. This is going to take us to Lübbenau Spreewald. Spreewald is a green Venice certified by UNESCO. It has 900 small islands and this place is going to be a heaven in front of you. I've boarded the regional train. It's super comfy with good leg space, so you'll not have any travel hassles. So please keep a look on the LED screens to check the stations. We need to get down at Lübbenau. So as I travel, I forgot to tell you, if you're aware, you can travel during the summer from June till August 2022 with your 9 euro ticket across Germany, and this place is one among them to plan your one day fabulous summer trip. I'm here finally at the Lübbenau Spreewald. Let's enjoy. While we landed into the Spreewald railway station, my husband and I, we are going to walk down for a kilometer to reach the nearest boat harbors. There are like 3 different harbors for each boat rides, 5-hour, 3-hour and 2-hour boat rides, and also separate harbors where you can get individual kayaks if you like kayaking. I missed my 5-hour boat ride because I arrived a bit late. Usually the 5-hour boat ride starts morning at 10 a.m, so be lucky to witness one. Use your 9 euro ticket during the summer. I came here in the month of March, which was like early spring and late winter. So though it looks super sunny and the wind is super cool, I was wearing hoods and I found few beautiful metal statues with fountain at the entrance of the harbors. A lot of Italian based restaurants to have yummy Italian cuisines and ice creams. I found few people taking some kayaks for their kayaking, and I'm taking this road that reaches the 3-hour boat ride, and there are a lot of souvenir shops, so you can buy a lot of souvenirs post your boat rides and make good shopping here. So I was here on a Saturday. I'm not sure about Sunday because in Germany most of the Sundays all the shops were closed. Since it's a tourist spot, you'll not be worried about the food because there are a lot of restaurants opened on weekdays. And don't miss out to check this Gürke pickle stalls. These are pickle stalls with yummiest pickles around, and this will never disappoint you. Have met my captain who takes me around Spreewald. Have paid 16 euros per person. So me and my husband, we are boarding this boat for a 3-hour boat ride around the Spreewald. So the captain will be explaining about the Spreewald culture and the heritage in German or in English. So I'm waiting for my fellow passengers to board in. So finally my boat started to move, and though it was like early spring, I was able to witness a lot of green pastures. The entire island, almost like 900 small islands here in Spreewald. It's beautiful. It's a 3-hour boat ride where 1 hour of lunch break and 2 hours of boat ride around the Spreewald town. The captain will be explaining about the rich heritage of Spreewald. It is also recognized by UNESCO as Green Venice. Here people live in sustainable living and really take care of Mother Nature, and they take anti-pollution seriously as their virtue. And all these boats are run manually. It is a pedaled boat run by the captains, and they don't have any motor boats. They ensure that, they caution that they don't pollute these water bodies, which is their source of income. Spreewald people live on farming because there are a lot of farmlands, and they don't use any vehicles that is made out of diesel or petroleum. Every vehicles here is run, even the buses, everything is run on electric, and even the boats are man-driven boats. So they don't have any motor boats that's run on petrol or diesel. Even the surprising factor is people, the Deutsche Post, which is the postal services of Germany, they also deliver the postals and shipments over these man-driven boats. That is something very fascinating. Just imagine you are getting your postal cards delivered through a boat. That will be really amazing, isn't it? So I am just enjoying the view around while I take this 2 3 hours of boat ride. I found some fluffy cows near the farmlands, and you will also see a lot of domestic animals, which if your kids are with you, they will enjoy this view of animals. And you can see a lot of ducks and a lot of bridges where you can pass by, and it's super cool. Here it is, some boat repairing area where we can see people repairing their boats. And a lot of farmlands around. So we can see a lot of water animals. If you're lucky enough, you can see some wild otters as well that's sailing again. So I found this place totally mesmerizing, super cool, and well maintained. That is like people here take this more judiciously to save and preserve their culture and nature. So they take this as their virtue altogether. I felt this place is like a living wallpaper that you see in a Google, or living wallpaper that you see in your screen shares of your laptop, because I was spellbound when I been through this 2 hours boat ride. It's truly a green Venice as certified by UNESCO, because people here have preserved it marvelously. While we are witnessing this heaven, we also realized we are ending this 3 hour of boat ride with 1 hour of lunch break finally. We halted at a restaurant where they parked the boats for 1 hour. We took some light lunch and also planned to take a walk around the restaurant, where we walked around the forest woods and took fabulous pictures. And we are back to shore finally, and we are going to taste some cucumber pickles. It's called as Gurke pickles. Gurke means cucumber in German. You can also shop some Gurke pickles for home, and it's yummy and truly new to my taste buds. And I also found few shops for souvenirs where you can buy cushion dolls and keychains shaped as Gurke, and also some driftwood decors. I bought a cute Gurke-shaped keychain and also took some fabulous pictures around. Spreewald is close to my heart. Please subscribe to my channel to find new such places around Berlin. Until then, bye.